What's going on, YouTube? Day 64 here. It's raining out right now, +3. I think there actually might be some sun poking out up top, maybe, or I'm just dreaming. But it's currently 11:30, and I have not made any riding plans yet. You know, after going for like 16, 18 hours a day every day, being able to sleep in a little bit for a day is kind of nice. So anyway, I think today what we're gonna do is we're just gonna go to the parking lot or go up to the Boulder cabin, and we're gonna meet some random people and tag along with them, or see if they're cool with me tagging along with them. You know, in 2018, I came out here by myself for a month. You know, I didn't have any friends here. I think I knew like two people, not even. And I would just either go up to the cabin, go to the parking lot by myself and meet random people and ask if I could tag along, or I'd just message people on social media and try and make some plans. So today we'll kind of do like we used to do and do that, since I know there's lots of people out there who think about coming here, but then they're like, ah, I don't have anyone to ride with. Typically, sledders are really welcoming to riders that are by themselves here. So I'm sure we'll meet some great people today and we'll see what happens. In the Boulder parking lot here now, just saw another guy pull in. Looks like he might be by himself. Maybe we'll go talk to him, see what he's doing. Okay, so his name's Marty. Turns out they're going on a sled recovery mission with Shady. If you've ridden Revelstoke, you've probably seen Shady around. He's got the boombox on his sled with the LED lights always going. I don't know if he's got the stereo going today, but so yeah, we're going for a sled recovery. Should be interesting. We got the No Peak crew today. Seems kind of funny to be riding with Shady here, since my dad used to ride with them back and shit, I don't even know when. I guess in the thousands. My dad used to always say he was quite the ripper with his open face snowboard helmet and the safety goggles, glasses. We'll see if he's still got it. We'll follow him around here. I don't know how you could possibly wear an open-faced snowboard helmet though. I'd be scared for my life with that. We're not doing any crazy riding or anything here. We're just, I think what we're trying to do is make a trail out for the down sled he's got up here. I just can't carry my speed very well through that last section. Oh yeah! Crap, look how much snow that is on top of that cliff. We'll drop into it here right from the top. So then it's a nice trail all the way down to get this sled out. Where's the best spot? Right there. Wow! Really? Come on now. Mm-hmm.
I think someone got a little buck wild into this tree here. I'll have to check out that bumper after. I was hoping all of the guys were gonna try and go up that little bit of a drainage we went up where we went under that tree. But I think we're gonna take the trail around. I was a little excited for some carnage though. Maybe not carnage, but you know, a couple stucks for sure. Well, we found the down sled up here. Now we're gonna work on connecting a trail through here to that drainage that I was pulling up earlier. And then tow it out. So obviously we still wanna do some riding while we're out here today. But first thing is first, we're gonna pack this trail for this sled. Give it time to set up so it'll be nice and firm for towing out. All right, this is the trail we came in on for up that drainage. Now just gonna connect it right up here. It's a lot closer than I thought, actually. And Bob's your uncle. Guess we'll go give him a hand. What are you doing?
Did you get me on your little video there?
I got you now.
I bet you do now.
Give Josh a hand here and get some of the snow out so it's a little easier to drive out. You think you're good?
Yeah, I think so.
Now he is still kinda sorta a little bit stuck. Hopefully it hits my trench and blasts right out of there, but we'll stick around to find out. Uh-oh, maybe not. Might go with a ski pole.
You want to try to take the back up with you?
Not really. I don't like lifting. There we go.
There we go.
There's the boom box everyone knows.
Broken sled, just stereo.
Oh, you got the stereo.
This is a stereo recovery, not a sled recovery.
Look it up, let's get it going. I don't understand how you wear that helmet, I gotta say.
Minus 20, minus 50, don't matter, buddy. If I'm on the trail going fast, it's a little chilly, but it's
just no feeling in your face.
No, I don't get frostbite every 4 or 5 years, maybe I might get a little touch, but.
Or just don't ride in the cold.
I'm too busy yelling all the time. There's lots of hot air around here.
I better just go for a quick hot lap here. We're at the top of the drainage.
We're at the top of the drainage, and I think my motor's blowing.
Is that what it is? Is he even gonna make it? All right, we're doing some squirrel riding here. Double back for the sled. You know, just go up to that right there. I should be able to go from there.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe we should have taken the 175. All right, we'll try it. We'll be back in a minute. It is set up to be a wheelie machine, so yeah, I mean.
So what do you do to?
Well, it's not, I shouldn't say it's set up to be a wheelie machine, but like, just the way my limiter strap is, the back springs, and yeah. I like the sled to feel playful, so I like to have some ski lift. I mean, there's definitely days, especially in the last week, where I should probably set it so it doesn't trench so much and rides up onto the snow a little better, but I'm making it work.
Yeah. All right.
Go help Josh.
Yeah, sure.
All right, guys, we're on a 175 turbo here for a minute. Said I wanted to try one out. Buddy with us here said I could take it for a minute. So why not? Wow. Wow, I feel like you could go anywhere on this thing. And he's on the 154 turbo. Can we see if we can do a bow tie on it? Wow, this thing's wild! Holy crap! I can definitely feel the length for the maneuverability. Fun. Try this again. Oh, almost lost my footing. That'd be nice, eh? Wreck the guy's turbo. What else can we do on it? He's not back yet, so I mean, I may as well keep riding for a minute. Should we see if we can make the straight pull up this hill? Some other Ontario boys, Jason McMurray and a bunch of them a while back. And it took us, I don't know, probably 15 tries at this hill. And I'd say the snow depth was pretty similar, and this just does it in one pull. That is wicked.
It's a lot more playful. Oh
yeah. This thing's wild though. When it goes up.
Oh yeah.
That's really cool.
Just get this high hill and just keep pointing up, eh?
Yeah,
just
like it.
Pulling, eh?
Yeah. Like no, on, for sure, I get it. Not my style, but.
I've never been on a 175 except for like a couple minutes last year, but definitely missed the playfulness, but.
Yeah. I think 65 would be the answer for you.
I mean, if you're just into exploring and getting places, this would.
It's a good guide sled.
Also get you in some trouble, though.
Oh, yeah.
Well, thanks for the rod.
Oh, no problem. Yeah. You're welcome.
I'm going to take this to where I took that and see where it'll go. Like, I climbed straight up that hill right there. What happened to Josh? Things, eh? So what number tree is this for today?
This is only number two tree.
Oh,
this is
dairy
of the day, isn't there? Dairy of the
day. Number three tree.
You do definitely get the dairy of the day.
No, we call these Josh specials.
Well, you don't watch the videos. This is definitely a dairy.
The other one was worse, but we got this one on camera.
Oh, I got the other one too. We need some GoPro footage of you going in though.
Okay, you guys gotta hit me up on Instagram, jd.dialedin.
Look at that hole.
Get out of so much with just the ski pole. Yeah.
Well, this is how you tow an extra sled. You tie it up tight to the bumper, and should work pretty well. Another awesome day out there in the mountains. Got to try 175, which is pretty awesome. Got the disco lights going over there. All right, guys, it's another day in the books. Another awesome day out there, meeting new people. We got to go for a test ride on the 175 Turbo. It was a lot of fun. It's really amazing what that sled's capable of. Pretty much just point shoot and it goes. It just keeps chewing too. And the side hill it'll hold. Yeah, it's a lot of fun. You know, you definitely lose some of the maneuverability going from the 154 to the 175, but I feel like if you spent enough seat time on the 175, you'd be able to throw it around pretty well. Probably not a sled I would own. You know, riding it today definitely makes me want to own one a little bit for those days where, you know, you want to explore somewhere, because, you know, I do a fair bit of exploring. But yeah, for those days you have an explore mission in mind, you know, you just have a destination you want to get to, this sled is definitely going to get you there. Might get you in a little bit of trouble on the way, but it's pretty cool what it's capable of. I would like to get out on it for more seat time. Whether that'll happen or not, who knows? But yeah, thanks for watching, guys, and we'll see you tomorrow.